Hello friends, welcome to my channel, and today we're gonna talk about DMVPN phase 2. Okay, so as I have already explained some of the topics of DMVPN in my previous video, if you have not watched my previous video, I'll request you to please watch that. I'll put the link of that video in the description so that you can watch that video before watching this. So I have explained what is mGRE and what is NHRP. So these two are very important to important for DMVPN to get to know about it. Today we are going to talk about Ceph, okay, how Ceph works, and what is spoke-to-spoke communication. So spoke-to-spoke communication we are going to see today. So I'll request you to please watch this video till the end so that you can understand Ceph and what is spoke-to-spoke communication, as well as in phase 2 what is the configuration, okay. And I will request you to please subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon so that whenever I upload any video, you'll get notification. So without any further delay, let's get started. So friends, in phase 1, what we have seen is whatever the communication happens from spoke to spoke, it goes via hub. So whatever traffic a spoke sends to spoke to, it goes from hub to spoke, because spoke is having the point-to-point tunnel from spoke to hub. That was the reason every time the traffic was going through this. But in phase 2, we'll be having a multipoint. The tunnel will be configured as multipoint. Multipoint means I don't know the destination, so that they can communicate from one spoke to another spoke directly without going through hub. So we are going to see that how this will happen, and why, and what is the use of hub in phase 2, that we are going to see in this video. During the configuration, I'll show you, because the understanding will be perfect if we do the practical, and during that time if I explain you. So we'll be starting the configuration first, then we'll be explaining it. So friends, in phase 1, what we have seen is whatever the communication happens from spoke to spoke, it goes via hub. So whatever traffic a spoke sends to spoke to, it goes from hub to spoke, because spoke is having the point-to-point tunnel from spoke to hub. That was the reason every time the traffic was going through this. But in phase 2, we'll be having a multipoint. The tunnel will be configured as multipoint. Multipoint means I don't know the destination, so that they can communicate from one spoke to another spoke directly without going through hub. So we are going to see that how this will happen, and why, and what is the use of hub in phase 2, that we are going to see in this video. During the configuration, I'll show you, because the understanding will be perfect if we do the practical, and during that time if I explain you. So we'll be starting the configuration first, then we'll be explaining it. So friends, we are going to log in to all the devices. Let me just log into all the devices first, okay, and we'll see the configuration what we have done in the earlier video. It is same as that one only. The difference will be we are making the tunnel as multi point. So we'll be going to the tunnel configuration and will remove the tunnel destination, and we are going to put as tunnel mode GRE multipoint and we'll shut it. After that we'll go to spoke to tunnel 0 and then we will remove this and shut it down and configure tunnel mode GRE multipoint. Sometime what happens if you do some configuration on tunnel, tunnel will not get established. For that reason we are just shut downing it so that the communication or the negotiation will be without any problem. Okay, so here we are not going to do anything, we just going to unshut it. So by the time it goes, so let me just wait for this and then okay, so we'll go to the configuration mode, the tunnel interface, tunnel 0, no shut, then we'll go here, no shut, and then we'll go here, no shut. Okay. Now, if you trying to see the IP route, the IP route is says 2.2.2.0, that is spoke to loopback is learning from 192.168 from hub tunnel IP address. Okay, so this is because why the behavior is because for every destination he is projecting, hub is saying that I am the next hop for spoke to. So we will change the behavior and in the EIGRP will remove the next hop one and we'll try to see now. So once the tunnel not the tunnel EIGRP neighborship comes up, we'll see now that now the 2.2.0 is reachable via 192.168.1.2. Okay, we have got the tunnel IP. Now if you see that NHRP, we have the mapping of tunnel and the MBMA address is only for hub, we don't have for spoke to. Then and also if you see show IP ceph for this IP, it says punt, that we don't have complete information about this IP address. Means if I want to reach from spoke 1 to spoke 2, I should have a route that we have, but we don't have a MAC address to reach there. Okay. Okay. So in that case, what ceph has is like, let's say if you want to reach to spoke 2 via this, ceph will check the FIB table, the forwarding table, and he will find out who is the next hop and he will try to get the IP address of the next hop, so that whenever traffic you sent from spoke 1 to hub or a spoke 2, he should have all the information, MAC address and the next hop IP address, so there will be no process switching. only fast switching will happen for that reason. Okay. So how the communication will happen? So we have already enabled the debug NHRP over here. So once you do trace route to 2.2.2.2 from spoke 1 to spoke 2, so first traffic will go from spoke 2 hub asking him that what is the NBMA address for 192.168.1.2. See, receive a resolution request via tunnel 0, route lookup for the destination. Actually, it forwards the request to destination 192.168.1.2. Okay. It sends an NHRP resolution request as well as the ping request in the same traffic. Hub received it and he forwards the traffic to spoke 2 because he is having the NBMA address of spoke 2. He forwards it. So he sent an NHRP, not like this. So NHRP request, hub forwards this NHRP request to spoke 2 because he is having the NBMA address. So once he gets once spoke replies to this, he also don't know the NBMA address of spoke 1. So again he will also send a resolution request to hub the same, and he will reply the ping traffic as well. Now the he forwards that traffic to spoke 1, and after that once the spoke gets the NBMA address, he will directly send the traffic to spoke 2. Now if you see, if we do the trace route, now the traffic will directly go to spoke 2. It will not go via hub. If you see now, at is directly goes to 192. So if we see NHRP mapping, will be having a NBMA address. So NBMA address is a public IP. So if you know the tunnel IP address, if you don't know the public IP address, how you will establish a tunnel between spoke to spoke? This is the internet. In production environment, if you try to understand this, this is the public IP address that spoke is having. So you should know how to reach the public IP address, then only you can reach to the loopback. Those information will be having on the hub, because we'll be having a dynamic one. So if you go to hub and if you try to see that show IP NHRP, he is having both the NBMA address because we are going and registering to hub. Why? Because show run interface tunnel 0, if you see, he is my server and I am going and registering myself to the server. So he is having all the information about it. So this is how phase 2 works, and this is how the spoke to spoke communication happens. And to understand that, if you understand Ceph, the same information Ceph was missing, that the ARP address, the same thing the NBMA address was missing in NHRP. So there is a correlation between Ceph and the NHRP. So this is what I wanted to show you guys, and I'll request you to please subscribe my channel to support me, and I want to thank you for you guys to viewing my this video, and I think it will be helpful for you.